defenses. So far, the man-to-man has seemed to cause trouble.
Mark Davis, the freshman, lost it down low. Kevin Thompson couldn't come up with it. Hurley's long pass, played off by Grant Hill to Thomas Hill. That's the three, and Duke is on the board first. Turnover from Hurley.
State Sun's doing a great job of getting back in this early part of the game, getting back in transition. When they turn it over, they've got to get back to defense.
Johnny Steele. Nice bounce pass underneath, and Thompson scores the first place of the whole pass. Has a 4-3 lead.
State doing a nice job of using Duke's aggression against them, going back door against the overplay.
3 minutes played here in Durham. Leitner. David, a spin away from the baseball, kind of a specialist, come off the bench and shoot the outside cover. They needed it this year. They want McGinn to go the full 9 innings. 6-5, Wolfpack. Thomas Hill, nothing but net with up jumper from 15 feet. 5 points for Thomas Hill.
Nice use of the pick. As I mentioned, Thomas Hill becoming a complete offensive player. Wasn't expected when he came to Duke. Hey, a little cat and mouse going on right now, though. Duke in their defense, they've really gone out and tried to play State for the three. State turned the tables and gone in looking for field goals. So if they're known to be the worst three-point defenders, they're cognizant of State's ability to shoot it. And State turned the tables by going inside.
Dish off to Thompson for two.
I'll tell you, the ball movement by State is about as good as I've seen against the Duke freshman.
6 points for Kevin Thompson, who leads all scores. Nice pass underneath. Leitner scores. 14-10 Duke. 13 and a half to play in the first half. Marshall is a freshman from Omaha, Nebraska. He was Mr. Basketball in the state of Nebraska last year. Guarded by Thomas Hill, Gugliotta.
Marshall, primarily because yesterday they worked on getting the ball, putting it on the floor, but going somewhere, not laterally.
12 minutes to play first half. Duke with a two-point lead. Hurley, nice pass. Leitner, couple of takes. Gugliotta, that's a three off the front rim. Hurley leads the break 4-on-2. Les Robinson has an interesting theory about three-point shots, Mike.
Now, if you want to talk about success in the seven wins, State shot 41% from three-point range, and in their five losses, they've only shot 33%, so the theory holds up.
They haven't been able to get three-point shots off tonight. They're 0-for-2. Curtis Marshall with the steal from Brian Davis. And they leave him alone for three. He says, thank you very much.
The 3 points have been allowing them to be open in that area. They've spread their defense more, and State's taking advantage of it by getting the ball inside on penetration.
NC State shooting 60% from the floor and still trailing. Battled back from a very serious knee injury. As a matter of fact, when Les Robinson came to NC State, the trainer told him, don't expect to see Jamie Knox on the basketball floor ever again. Early, great pass. Thomas Hill with the slam dunk to give Duke a six-point lead. Marshall nearly lost the skip pass. Marshall picked it to the collar. Wide open for three is Seale.
They have to keep making those open three.
Well, that's what they're going to get now that the Duke defense is starting to help out a lot more on penetration. You got to be able to dish it off to the open guy.
Guaranteed Park.
But I'll tell you, the story of those kind of plays is the fact that there's no pressure on the ball. You allow the passer to see inside, a clear view.
Passer that time was Thomas Hill. This is Gugliotta off the glass for two.
4 points now for the senior from Huntington Station, New York.
Early on the floor with Thomas Hill, Lang, Parks, and Davis. That's a three for Bonner.
Really big lineup with Parks and Leitner in the game. Should make for some offensive rebounding.
Seale has Gugliotta. And
worked hard to build up that body. Bobby Hurley guarded by Curtis Marshall. Leitner underneath the Parks. He fouled, the basket counts, and Mark Davis. Fouled by Davis, playing with two. Parks had the easy basket. He would have been served just to let him have the two. Duke has hit seven of its last eight field goals now. Parks missed the free throw. The lead is six. Lugliano cuts it to two.
Great body control for a guy his size. Stopped on a dime and then changed the ball in midair.
Parks. Now Brian Davis. Davis to Brian Hill. Strong over Seals. Nice pass. Thompson from Marshall. Parks got a piece of him. And deflected it to Leighton. And the steal by Marshall. Pulls up for three. Curtis Marshall. Bobby Hurley off to Parks. Pressure cut off by Gugliotta. Then he bounced the pass off the knee of Leighton. Three on one, the break at the moment. Gugliotta with the slam. For NC State. The lineup for Duke is now Hurley with Thomas Hill, Brian Davis, Christian Leighton, and Grant Hill. Hurley drives away from Marshall, scores, and he was fouled.
Bobby Hurley recognizing the defense. Christian Leitner has Kevin Thompson pulled out far away from the basket. He sees the open lane. No shot blocker, no post defender.
Kevin Thompson, certainly one of the most improved players in the ACC. He started coming on over the last 10 games of last season. 37-32 Duke, under 5 minutes to play in the first half.
Good job by Grant Hill backing the defense, pulling them out to spread the floor to get his team a little more focused offensively.
Thomas Hill. For Duke. 8 points with the ball with 3.5 minutes to play in the first half. Marty Clark. Now Davis. NC State back in the man-to-man. Jamie Knox is in the game for the Wolfpack.
Time by holding his position, a nice block out as an offensive player.
Davis underneath the park, Leighton on the bench at the moment. Davis for three, rebound all along. Grant Hill for
Grant Hill, the son of former NFL great Calvin Hill.
Since the lights have gone out, Duke is one of five from the line. Gugliotta hits a three.
Pack all year, just when you think they're going to get pushed out of this game, they come right back.
Might be difficult to tell on your television set at home, but the lights are still dim here at Cameron Indoor Stadium. Parks didn't get the bounce. The rebound hit the floor. Parks stayed with it. Hurley for three.
You look at the first half stats. Both teams shot the ball very well in the first half. Some interesting numbers at the bottom. The three-point field goal.
The other gaudy statistic for the field goal. Duke getting some great and easy opportunities, and as we mentioned, it's all off the defense. See a nice job by Bobby Hurley stepping in the passing lane. Duke loves to get out in transition, and once again, Hurley sees a little bit of English on that pass. He sees right in the lane. The other side of it is State. We talked about their offense is certainly keyed when they can get up enough three-point attempts, and they do that in transition. Marshall on the steal just stepped up to the line.
And we're underway in the second half. NC State with the ball trailing by 11. Seal guarded by Hurley. Sheds Hurley. Gugliotta. He led all scorers in the first half with 13 points. Mark Davis playing with 3 fouls. As the first point. Lead Duke in scoring at the moment with 12 each. Mark Davis. Rebound Hurley. Thomas Hill wide open to three. And
Thomas Hill.
You can tell the State players, even though they just came out of the halftime a little bit winded, very slow to react to the ball as it's loose out there.
This is Grant Hill, guarded by Gugliotta. Hurley lays it in.
White, who has such an array of offensive power, It's very difficult to defend. You watch here, so intense are the State players in guarding their own men, they just leave a wide open lane for Bobby Hurley to penetrate. Nobody.
Duke has outscored NC State 8-2 here in the second half. Marshall, long drive away from Hurley for the two. He now has eight.
Nice decision by Leitner not to really waste a foul on that at this particular time. But they know they're going to get a chance to go against him.
The lead is 17 for Duke. Marshall with the steal. He's played well. Gugliotta lays it in. Hurley let it pass. The two, 15 points now for Tom Gugliotta. Hurley wide open for three. Hurley hustles, tracked down his own rebound. What a pass. Grant Hill with the
double figures in 8 of the 12 Wolfpack games.
Well, you hit the nail right on the head. It's tough enough to come in here as a senior, let alone as a freshman, to come here and execute and do a lot of the things well, and they've done some of those things.
Hurley to Grant Hill.
Well, Grant Hill, we talk about him being a complete offensive player. He scores a lot of points off of dunks just like that on the alley-oop. If teams come in here, and they won.
Bodies leave Cameron Indoor Stadium with a win. But Bill McCaffrey's missed free throw was tipped in by Christian Leitner to send the game into overtime. At the end, Bobby Hurley's defense on Chris Corciani kept him from hitting a three-point shot. And the Duke Blue Devils and Coach K narrowly survived.
Being a little moist at the end.
Steal with the steal. The lead is 22 for Duke. With 11 at the half. They doubled the margin in just more than 5 minutes. Victor Newman hits a 3.5 minutes to play. Top-ranked Blue Devils, a 19-point lead. Hurley's pass intercepted by Seal. Davis the man back. Seal scores over Davis.
Is that a New Year's resolution?
No. Observation.
Yes. Being a man of the law, you are always extraordinarily fair.
Leitner hits a three.
David Klingler among those in the Senior Bowl on Saturday.
You have good seats for that, Sean?
I'll be at the East West Shrine game.
What a busy time it is in Palo Alto. Bobby Hurley hits another three.
To lead this team down the road in the coming year.
Mark Lewis with his first shot of the night. No good. The rebound, Clark. Thomas Hill. Terrific night.
And as you can see, only Virginia was a test. Now the speculation is, can Duke run through the conference season undefeated?
And Hill lays it in, and he was fouled.
See, we'll take a look at some very fundamentally sound basketball despite the score. Hill fed the post and then made the cut. Something that time, Gugliotta fronted the postman, Leitner, and the pressure was applied on the passer, and they couldn't get it in.
Hurley with the steal to pass by Newman. He saw that coming all the way, and Bobby now has 9 points
undefeated. As we see, with a huge lead and most of the starters in the game, they continue to play with 100% intensity.
That's the thing, the champion, the ingredient of the champion, that you don't let up.
Leitner.
Rebounded by Lewis.
When you consider that Duke coming into tonight's action had attempted fewer three-point shots than any team in the league. Oh. NC State fired up the most. Marshall missed a three. Hurley off the Davis. He's fouled.
Last year, Mr. Basketball in Alabama and Newman, they talk about Les Robinson's personality and his style for being the two biggest reasons why they came to NC State, and I think we'll continue to see that in the coming years. He's a wonderfully nice man, and he plays that kind of offensive
shooting style that attracts quality players.
And I think the ingredient we're talking about is loyalty. He recognizes as a former NC State player that he is a guardian.
Had an awful lot of injuries, broken collarbone, severe laceration to his hamstring, and it's just a wonder that he's back out here playing right now. A lot of hard work and a lot of dedication.
You've been saying
in it all evening. I'm proud of you.
Thank you, Len. Don't know what that was. Marshall threw it off the backboard. Hello. Brian Davis. This is Marty Clark out there with Blakely, Meek, Parks, and Lang.
You're right, that's
sign of things to come. The Duke basketball program, Meek. Left alone.
But even with the 9 o'clock start here, he didn't have 10 or 15 minutes to talk to the good folks from ESPN.
Early focus for the pass to him.
I'll make the overture to play the week. I didn't
four. Sophomore from Heidelberg, Germany. Meek scores over Knox.
Meek does a nice job on the block, taking his man down as deep as he can and using that big body to turn to the basket.
The crowd cheers as a walk-on. Ron Burst is getting ready to check in. Robinson unselfishly off to Steele. Nice shot off the
ground. You can see where Donnie Steele with more playing time. This is only his seventh game. With more playing time, adapting to the system, where he's going to be one heck of a player.
Good hand. And the follow by Antonio Lang.
Not their best start. That came back in 1986
when they went 16-0.
Set him up, folks. Somebody set him
he's
up.
He's open. Ass couldn't get it to him. Fletcher, stolen by Burst. He still has time.
Oh,
what an unselfish player. Give him the assist, 110. And the North Carolina State Wolfpack, 75. For Len Elmore, Sean McDonough saying, so long.